Hi everyone, I'm Laura Gale Locke. On this edition of Local Loop, we're going to tell you about an exciting event coming up in October. It is the Kansas Business Matchmaker event. We have three guests here with us today. We have Chris Hazlett with the city's purchasing department, Karen Page with the Kansas World Trade Center organization. She's president and CEO, and also Wayne Bell, the director of the Wichita office of the Small Business Administration. Thank you guys for being here today.
Thank you.
Well, first, just tell me a little bit about this event.
All right. It is the 2011 Kansas Business Matchmaker. It's intended to match buying agents from federal organizations, from the private sector, prime contractors, with sellers or potential suppliers. We think it's really going to be a great opportunity for small businesses in the area to get the opportunity to meet one-on-one with these buyers, to tell a little bit about what they do, their capabilities, and to eventually lead to contracts. This is a really nice opportunity, we think, in the area.
Mm-hmm. And tell me when it's going to be held and where.
Okay, the event takes place October 19th. At the Wichita State Metroplex here in Wichita. We're anticipating anywhere from 200 small businesses to as high as 400 small businesses, and anywhere from 50 to 100 buyers.
That's quite a bit. Karen, will you give me some examples of some of the major companies that'll be there?
Well, I think it's a really great opportunity. There's some really great companies that are going to be there, including I think it's Spirit Aerosystems has signed on as well as one corporations, as well as local government organizations as well. So you're going to get a really nice mix of the public and private sector, those larger organizations that have supply chain needs, and just really giving small businesses an opportunity to get with those buyers in the same room at the same time and be able to make their pitch and hopefully result in contracts.
And have you guys ever done anything like this before?
You know, there have been similar matchmaking events in our area in the past, but this one has a little special focus that we're really excited about. We have the ability to pre-match the seller abilities the seller capabilities, the small businesses, with the buying needs. So, for example, those buyers that would be in attendance from Hawker Beechcraft or Boeing or Cessna, when they register, those buyers are going to identify the NAICS codes or the industries that they're looking for suppliers in. And then the suppliers, when they register, they would identify their capabilities in the industries they serve. And so those two would be matched in advance of the event. So when they come to the event, they're going to have the opportunity to do these one-on-one meetings in a speed dating fashion. So it really ought to be pretty neat, a speed dating fashion. They're going to do the elevator pitch on their business, exchange cards, talk about the prospect of contract opportunities, and move forward from there.
That sounds like a great idea. Chris, what's the city's role going to be?
It's going to put us there, our buyers there, with the small businesses so that they can introduce themselves and their businesses, kind of let them know about what we're looking for, as well as then what they do. We can kind of let them know what proposals are going to be out there, what solicitations are going to be out there, and not just with the city, but with other governmental entities. I don't know if Sedgwick County is going to be there or the
yes.
USD 259 school district, but there's also going to be Heartland PTAC there, which helps businesses with the federal government and federal contracting. So it's going to give them the opportunity to kind of find out what the government's needs are.
So how helpful will that be to you?
Very much so. I do work a lot with small businesses, so getting them the opportunity to network and hear about our opportunities and get them in front of the buyers is tremendous opportunity for these small businesses. So that's how it will help.
Mm-hmm. So if a business is interested in attending, what do they need to do to be prepared for this speed dating session?
Okay, great question. Really what the business owners need to do is this. First of all, they need to go out to the website to look into registration and move forward from there. And they can find the information just by simply going to the SBA website, sba.gov, that'll get them to this event. Now, some of the tips that they ought to consider or things they ought to consider have a summary, either a one-page summary or a brochure of some type that describes their business and their capabilities. They also need to have business cards. They need to be prepared. These meetings are going to be very short. You're not going to have a lot of opportunity to elaborate on what you do, but you will get the opportunity to exchange key information about what you do and who you are and how to follow up, that sort of thing. And be sensitive, because there will be other small businesses in attendance. It will be a great networking opportunity, as Chris has pointed out. The other thing that's a great benefit are the breakout sessions that Karen spoke of earlier. We're planning a session that Karen's going to lead on exporting, how businesses that may be positioned to export today, how they can go about doing it. There'll be some other folks in the room that'll talk about how exporters obtain financing and other opportunities that exporters might consider. There's going to be a breakout session that has to do with government contracting. As Chris pointed out, the Heartland PTAC will be there, and they will be leading that session, and they'll specifically be talking about how to go about government contracting. There are other sessions planned, how to finance a business. Certainly SBA with our loan programs will be a part of that session, as well as other partners. The Kansas Department of Commerce, for example, would be a part of that session. They've got some finance options through Network Kansas that'll be discussed. So there'll be a host of resource partners, as Chris has pointed out. In addition to the prime contractors and large companies that will be there and have their buying agents there, there will also be these resource partners and other folks in the room that can really help small business owners move forward.
Yeah, you get a lot of great information, it sounds.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Karen, tell me more about the session that you're leading.
In the exporting session, which we're titling Export Now, to try and motivate people to take a look at that opportunity. Anytime we have an opportunity to help Kansas companies export more, that just means really new dollars to the Kansas economy, which is of benefit. So anytime that the Kansas World Trade Center has an opportunity to be involved in, to encourage, to educate, we're just right there. So on this session, what we'll be covering is we'll look at local resources that are available both from the public and private sector, including the Kansas Department of Commerce Trade Division, as well as the U.S. Department of Commerce Export Assistance Center. I'll be moderating, so I'll throw in information here and there. And also, if we can meet someone's schedule, then we'll also see if we can bring in an exporter to talk about how they utilize certain resources and other things that that they might use to have helped them in their success. Mm-hmm. So I think it will be beneficial. I try to when I have a chance to moderate a session like that, try to make it as interactive as possible. Make sure that those attending, those in the audience, have a chance to answer questions, because when you get a panel of people like that together, it's a really good opportunity just to fire questions at them and to learn from them right then and there. You don't have to schedule a meeting later. You just pick their brains while they're there. So we'll try to make sure that happens. I think it's really important, the combination of things that are occurring at the Kansas Business Matchmaker. First, that there's a gathering of buyers and sellers, and you're putting them together basically in one room or mm-hmm. one building. And then to enhance for the success rate, the fact that we're able to pre-match the needs with the capabilities. So you're going to, even though it's a speed dating session, you only have 12 minutes or whatever it is, you're already talking to someone that needs what you say you have. So there's a really great opportunity for, you don't have to take that long. They already know that there's a fit. Mm-hmm. So that, and then you combine that with the education and the breakout sessions that Wayne was talking about, whether it's Export Now or whether it's access to capital and financing, or how do you contract with the federal government, or how do you work with a large supplier. Those things really is a right combination, we believe, to really make the conference a success. And our definition of the conference being a success is if people have an opportunity to meet and to learn, and if there could be some contracts that occurred just from the Kansas Business Matchmaker, it would be fantastic. I mean, that would be a win for all of us. So
absolutely.
I agree. Something I'd like to highlight that Karen made me remember was the aerospace supplier panel that's planned. We think this is really going to be a nice addition to the event, with so many smaller subcontractors in the area that supply the aerospace industry, and certainly there's a lot of interest in being a supplier with the aerospace industry. We're assembling a panel that will talk about the requirements that suppliers ought to be aware of, and the process for getting certified to be a supplier with Boeing or Hawker Beechcraft or Cessna, so on and so forth. I really think that's going to be a good addition. And also, one of the things I wanted to mention before it slipped my mind was to make sure that we know that this is co-hosted not only by the SBA, but this is also hosted by the Wichita State Kansas Small Business Development Center, which is on site in the WSU Metroplex. So they'll certainly be closely involved with everything in the breakout sessions, and we think it's going to be really nice. Another thing that we have added, we have invited SBA's administrator, Karen Mills, to come out and be a keynote speaker. Now, we haven't received confirmation yet. I'm very optimistic on this. Kansas is one of the states that she is has indicated she wants to get out to in the near future. Hopefully the timing will work. Stay tuned.
Yeah, that'd be very exciting.
All right.
Karen, will you talk just a little bit more about the success your organization has had? I think maybe people aren't necessarily always aware of how much success we have when it comes to exporting.
Oh, thank you for asking that question. The Kansas World Trade Center plays a role. So there's many partners that we work with, informal partners and formal partners that we work with to help Kansas companies have success in the international markets. So we're one piece of the action, and we try to take a very strong leadership role, but we're one piece of it, so I want to make sure that it's clear that U.S. Department of Commerce has the resources available, as well as Kansas Department of Commerce, Trade Division. We all work together to help Kansas companies. But the Wichita area in particular, and a recently released study from the Brookings Institute out of Washington, D.C., noted Wichita metro area as being one of the number one exporters in the nation. For the period that they were studying, so from up to 2008, mm-hmm. prior to the recession. So we have to regain our number one position. But it's very interesting because people don't realize how successful we are at exporting. So the study really pointed out a couple of really interesting things. One is Wichita metro area is number one in the nation for percentage of exports of the state's total. It's half of the state's total exports is what this area in Wichita provides to the export success. And the second thing is, it's the number one, actually, fastest growing in the nation per capita exports. So those are really two important things to have been called out by a third party in Washington, D.C. Maybe perhaps the most interesting thing is President Obama, in his State of the Union address in February of this year, announced the National Export Initiative. And the National Export Initiative calls for the United States to double its exports in a 5-year period. The Brookings Institute took an examination of that. Is it possible? And if it's possible, have we done it before? And if we've done it before, when was that? And who's done it? So the United States did double its exports in a 5-year period. It was in the 40s, though. So we haven't done it in a while. So it's a good challenge for us. Americans like a challenge. But there was only 4 metro areas in the nation that actually doubled their exports in the 2003 to 2008 period. Wichita was one of them. So there's only 4 in the nation. And people don't realize how good we are at this. I mean, I think that's part of our culture. As Wichitans, as Kansas, we work hard, we figure out how to get things done, we innovate, and we just go about doing our business. And I think this, the Kansas Business Matchmaker is one example of that. Wayne really had this idea, and then he started talking to the rest of us saying, hey, I think we can do this. Let's work together and get it done. Mm-hmm. And I think that is the same reason that Wichita companies have had such export success. They build great products, and people all over the world want to buy them, and Wichita companies go out there and sell them. Mm-hmm. It's a great thing.
Well, it just sounds like a tremendous opportunity for people to come and pick your brains and get all that wealth of knowledge you guys have to boost their businesses and grow it.
I agree. One final thing I guess I want to add is that this is really a good opportunity for women-owned small businesses, small businesses that are in rural communities. We really want to get those folks plugged into the various companies and the governmental agencies that will be represented, so that we can begin to get some of those folks into the supply chain. This is something that will ultimately create jobs in our community. I think it's a great example of public and private partnership working together to generate something that's good for our community and the small business community.
Are there any minimum qualifications a business needs to meet in order to be able to participate?
Not really in this one. They just need to go through the process of registration. They could be a sole proprietor or someone who's aspiring to be a business owner. But they would have to go through the steps of in the registration indicating the industries that they're going to serve. They probably ought to have, you know, I guess it would be safe to say they probably should be in business, and if they're not in business, boy, they ought to be very, very good at what they do so that they can sell, you know, the idea and the concept to the prospective buyer.
And maybe Chris can talk more about this, but each buyer has a supplier certification process or supplier requirement, so there's no really minimum requirements to participate in the Kansas Business Matchmaker, but dependent on the buyer that they're trying to do a contract with, then there might be some requirements.
Right. And that was exactly my thought, and you kind of stole what I was going to say as well. With the city, we have our own Emerging Business Enterprise Certification Program, which is for small businesses that have been open at least 6 months. And then the state also has a disadvantaged business program, and the state rep is going to be down from the Department of Commerce. So it's a real good advantage for the businesses that aren't part of that to come in and find out what's the advantage and the benefit of becoming a certified company. You know, what's it going to do for me? And because there are requirements to the programs, the city's EBE is a little easier to be certified in than the state's DBE. But you know, we're happy to talk to them about the differences between the two programs, why you should be certified in both if you do qualify for it. So yeah, by all means, there are no minimum requirements for this workshop, but there are a lot of certification programs out there that there are some requirements for, and this is a great opportunity to have them right there in front of everybody at the same time and kind of hear about what those are and the advantages of them.
Is this something that you think would be great for smaller municipalities to attend?
You know, smaller municipalities are looking for the same thing that the larger ones are as well. They have a vendor and a supplier base that they need to purchase from. So by all means, if they're interested in selling to the city of Wichita, they could be interested in selling to City Derby.
Or if they're interested in accessing qualified suppliers, then they could register as a buyer,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
Yep, absolutely. So yeah, by all means, a smaller municipality will get a lot out of this as well if they come and participate. Yep.
Great.
Right. So if a interested party would go out to Wichita State's website on the University Conferences site, they'll see registration there and a link for the event. If they go out to the SBA website, they can certainly get to the event registration from there also. We are sending out hundreds of emails on this event and trying to get it in front of a number of buyers and sellers. We would love it if we had 500 or so small businesses and 200 buyers. I mean, that would be just a home run on this thing. So I think at the end of the day, it's going to be a great opportunity to match buyers and sellers. That will ultimately lead to contract opportunities.
And growth for our economy.
Absolutely.
Anything else either of you would like to add before we go?
I think Wayne said it all. I think he summarized it pretty well.
You did love that.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
I would like to add one thing, and that's just to really thank Wayne for having the vision and putting this together. And from the Kansas World Trade Center, we're just happy to be a part of it. The fact that Wayne said, hey, can you help with this? We're like, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Is any time that we can be a part of something that will help Kansas companies, help the local companies do better economically, do better in their business, is an amazing thing. And it takes someone like Wayne stepping forward to say, let's do this. Let's put this together. And it takes a leader. And he's been a great leader. So thanks, Wayne, for
doing this. Thanks a lot, Karen. I mean, no doubt about it. We have a great community, a great network of resource partners that are really here to benefit the small business community and the business community in general in our area. So this is something that it has been a great collaborative event. And I'm just looking forward to this thing coming to fruition and looking forward to October 19th.
Well, thank you guys for being here, and you're going to have to come back on after the event wraps up so you can tell us all about your successes.
That'd be great.
Thank you.
All right, and thank you for watching. We'll leave you the information on the Kansas Business Matchmaker event coming up October 19th.